Well, you're kind of wondering what that was all about. Anyway, I figured we have stayed way too long in this. I've ran the simulator out, and we are eight hours from the end of mission. I've tried several different ways. It is very long. Submarine operations are very long, and I think they're very tedious. And I think that if you actually watch these, you'll learn something, but it's far in between. So I'm going to try to redo my outlook here and kind of follow an idea of how this should work out. Now, the whole game for this is we will try to teach and learn at the same time, because I'm learning a lot. I've got everything open. I've got multiple windows open. I have the manual sitting here, so I can sit here and look at this manual, which is trying to drive me absolutely nail crazy, but that's fine. So to go on, I don't want to talk too much. Everybody always has this talk. So what happened in the beginning? The first hour was a set of three skirmishes. The major change I did on this was when you first get the scenario, get the mission editor up, you have an ASW. Now what I did is you had two ASW zones in here. You can see them right here. I selected them all and I made it one ASW zone. And then I applied all aircraft that I could get in there to do ASW. So we have found two Foxtrots, a November, the Victor II, a Whiskey, a Zulu. We finally got that Juliet out of the way. He did take out two ships on me. So, and we also got a Charlie. We lost so far this daily class, the DDH 205 St. Laurent, and the F Oslo. So these kind of hurt, because these two ships are badass ships when it comes to being able to defend themselves. Problem is it's not telling us. But when I was looking at the explosions, these are big explosions. They're not the little clack things. So they're shooting nukes at us. And so, you know, we're using nuclear depth charges too. So I guess what's good for the goose is good for the gander. And we're really at it in here. Somebody mentioned earlier that I should do something like this. I'm not sure if I really like this. But if you want to see the old man that's actually doing this, there's the face. I really don't leave this up here. Maybe I should when I'm talking about stuff. And showing my diagrams of how I think I'm going to swing around. When I do my flanking stuff, and it's all about flanking in the tactical games. Now, the games you'll see me play other than DCS, which I love flying. That's why I play DCS. It works there, too, because a flank is what you really want. And that means they're coming head on, and you send out flankers out to the sides, kind of like that. When he's coming in, you can see the two flankers coming on each side. That's what you want. You want to kind of get him in there, and then if all else, get him in a pincher. So, and this works with Armor 3. If you're fighting these missions in Armor 3, which have AI, this works great, because what they're going to do is use the same thing on you. You always use flankers. You go out and get their flankers and then kill them all. On the ships, you will see what my tactics on the ships were, is I want the ships, like this guy, I want his cone. See, he can't see the inverted V here. He can't defend himself back there. So you want this part of your group to be facing that way or sideways to a unit. Sometimes they can get through, sometimes they can't. We had a really bad experience where we had two missile boats out there, and that's how we lost those three ships. Anyway, I'm going to turn this back off because I really don't think you, maybe if you want to see me, it really doesn't matter. But we're going to turn that off so you don't have to put up with that. The next thing we're going to do here is show, let me fireball this thing up, as that we're in 8 hours. So I figured I'd just show the last 8 hours of the fight, knowing that we've already lost some ships, justified the ships. And I've been running for about 3 hours. This thing has been running 4 hours this afternoon at fireballing. There's some questions I have. Why is it pulse like that? Is that something I'm doing? Is that talking? It's flashing some kind of weird thing? But is it a key that I don't know that's being pressed automatically? There goes another bird. We will find these guys if it doesn't go. I think there's one up in here. We kept getting a pop right in here. But when we got all the birds up in there, couldn't find him. So the big lesson you learn, if you learn anything and want to play this, and of course I have to apologize, this is not Chains of War. This is Northern Inferno 1975, not Chains of War. So we're not going to be fighting the Chinese. We're going to be fighting the Russians and the Czechs and, you know, the Soviet Union. Or basically the Warsaw Pact. Now, hint of interest here. 1975, I was in Germany at a place called the Folded Gap. That's where we used to go train to kick the shit out of the Russians on a nuclear biological battlefield and plus a tank fight. Man, I am glad that never happened. But that's a little tidbit. So it's coming down fast. So the whole idea, I want to play background music, but I was looking it up. I can play music as long as I'm willing to be demonetized. And if anybody remembers the first video that I put up, I said, don't worry about the money. I'm not in this for money. I'm in this for fun and have people listen to me. Because maybe I'll bring up other subjects like, you know, programming, how to write your Lula scripts to make this run a little better, because it's all based on Lula scripts. I'm also going to keep these guys going on TacView, because I don't use it. I haven't been using it. The reason I haven't been using it is I don't like to cheat that much. I really was tempted earlier. And when we stop the game at the end of the game, I'll crank up TacView and see if what we missed. But this video, the other ones are just going to get deleted. I can't justify, you know, making you guys watch 3 hours of this unless you're interested. And if you are, give me a comment and throw a like there so I can answer you. And I'll answer you. I may not answer today, but I promise that I'll answer you. If you have questions of what I'm doing, throw it in the chat. Definitely throw it in the chat, and I will stop it, and I'll show you what I'm doing and why. Because that's the whole idea. Other ones are just doing everything. If you want to know why something doing it or how it's doing it, then I'm going to add an email address somewhere so you can actually email me directly if you want to. I don't have anything like Patreon. You'll never hear me say go to Patreon. I don't have an account. I do support a couple of other people that has a good content. Bullion, I'd support him if he put up more videos, but he's kind of my idol with this. I think that, you know, one of the most knowledge. Other people, they're pretty good at it, but I'm gonna go back over to Bulligan or Bulligan, and ask him some questions about this flashing. I maybe set my system up wrong, or did something to where there is something pressing a key somewhere. You know, I just don't know. I went through all my wiring to make sure that it wasn't, because sometimes I have issues with the flight controllers because I'm running two or three flight controllers. Did you guys watch my landing over there when I was over there in Georgia? I am proud of that. I got my landing speed. I went and checked my landing speed. My vertical landing speed was 5 feet a second. And man, anything under 20 is great. So check that out. There's a nice smooth landing. And the runways were nice and long and they were smooth. When it comes to 3PD, I have a lot of stuff for 3PD. We can take you up into Alaska with real maps and take you to Glacier Bay. They didn't have too much in Georgia. You know, Georgia was a really strange place because I was looking for more in-depth charts on Georgia, and it just like a wasteland or something. I'm not sure. Anyway, getting back to this is my game. This is the game I love playing. You'll see it all the time. If you have suggestions of how my tactics are running right now, I just make them out. I was looking at the mission editor here, and it's got a couple of different things that I noticed. See, you can see, okay, this I might use in the future. What's the minimum number of aircraft required to trigger the mission? And I think that is just great. That is going to come up because we're going to fight these bears again. But then they're not going to be just recon bears. Those TU-95s, they're going to be loaded down with ship killers. Hundreds of them. And I'll tell you right now, the only way to overcome that is to have your aircraft a heavy, heavy cap that shoots those missiles down. And if you get through one, get back, rearm, and get back out of there, because there's a second one waiting for you. They always are. Because that scenario hasn't changed in years. But I was looking at all this, and, you know, the active status, and I went back here and I was looking at my doctrine. When you pull the doctrine up, I got it all popping up here so you don't have to, it doesn't irritate you. So you can do the things you want to look is what they're inherited, right? Now, my weapons were tight. The use of nuclear weapons, I granted. Okay? Or inherited for the game, but I granted them. My ECOM, when they go out with this mission, they will go out with everything running, which I don't really want to do right now. What I should have done is, like, say, take this plane. I should have given him orders. His plot is course. High, okay, get him to right there, and then maybe give him a little more, and then that's it. But what I would do is tell him that his sensors, well, everything goes up again, his sensors, his radars would be off. Okay? Everything's off. Okay? Until he reaches this waypoint here. And then we turn his sensors on. And those sensors will come on with his radar on, his sonars on, and he's going to be doing offensive ECM. I don't think there's any aircraft out there that deal with it, but are we running as hot as we can? Yeah. But I figure we got probably 30 minutes left. This would be one full video. And then I just wanted to, you know, do the end to show that it can be ran. If I wouldn't have lost those ships, I got a major victory now. I'd have maxed out at 800. But I'm waiting for it to say mission accomplished, major victory, whatever it's going to give me. And then we can move on to the next phase of this, which is going to be more intense, and we will probably give full live content, and then we'll go back out, and if the whole segment, we'll stop it every 30 minutes, and if that 30 minute second really didn't have anything in it, then we'll just dump that one and we'll just leave the ones that actually have either combat, contacts, or missile fire. It's just basically fighting. I like the fights. I do wish that it does make you think about what's happening here, because these subs that are out here, quite seriously, see, it doesn't work. I got to get this to work. And I don't know what I'm doing wrong. I just don't know. The weirdest part about this. Trying to look up and see what. No, I'm not going to do that either. What I really want to know is how many submarines he had out there. And the Battle of Order doesn't show anything, which is goofy. But 4 hours we're running down. So I do, guys, you know, if you guys got comments, please put them in the comments. That's the only way I'm going to know if I'm getting better, if I'm doing something wrong. I don't think there's a lot you can do wrong here. I do think out of the box, like you saw, when I saw those missiles being launched, I made two sub search areas, and I reassigned all the aircraft to those two subs. I still lost. But I got the sub in the end. Now, I know the Juliet got hit, but I wonder if there's another Juliet out there. And I wished, a couple of the things I'm going to suggest is that if we get hit with nuclear weapons, that they make a big, big deal out of it. We also need to know when we're fighting what the atmosphere is like. Is it radioactive? Are our pilots flying in you know 800 or 900 rads rads per hour, where they're going to die when they land, or they just melt in the seat? Things like that. That I'm going to suggest that in the forums, that we have some type of indicator. If they're using nuclear weapons, there has to be something that shows us that. That way we know if we're not using nuclear weapons, they pop one, we know, okay, we're gonna retaliate with nuclear weapons. So I promise this one's a little bit more. I started this simulation on this one at 12:30 this afternoon. It is now 5:35 in the afternoon. So it's taken that long to run the 3 days. Because no matter what I do or seem to do, is there's that line, but I don't care. I really don't care. Is if I go like a minute and I press that, and I've even said it even says right here, it goes to advance time by 1 minute, alt 2. So I go over here, I hit alt and 2, no change. Let's try Alt 3. Alt 3. Again, no change. But we're getting down there. We're 3 hours. So, where's he going? Let's route him up here. I don't want to take him up there at all. He stay right there. What's he doing? I wish he had aircraft. And if you don't watch them, they'll cavitate on you. And that's just asking for those submarines to find out exactly where you're at. But we're covering this. These sonar buoys, disappointed. Disappointed. I'm, you know, okay, and so let me show you how these sonar buoys work. Okay, so in the ocean, you have a thermal grate. Which where you get water and then you get really cold water underneath it. So what happens with sonar and noise thing, it bounces off the top of that. So a submarine could be right below it, down underneath the band, underneath that cold water, you won't see them. So what happens here is when they throw these things down, this goes deep. It's at 292 feet. This goes high, 131 feet. So it's just above the layer, the thermal layer, or just below the thermal layer, and we're pinging. And these guys are pinging their ass off. And I don't understand where we're not getting more hits. And I'm still looking in the manual how to filter out the biologicals. Oh, I just filter out. Unless it's not a biological one. Well, that's supposed to filter out. That really fucking looks good.
Yeah,
so it kind of turns them green. What is that? Two biologicals at one place? Filter them out. We don't care. So, while we're waiting, we can play with these. We're running these layers. So that gives us terrain. Let's see, what else can we do here? Take the cities. Oh, we can add the cities. Okay, that didn't seem to do much. 3D, day and night. Makes it easier to look at. Kind of like that. Land cover. Not too sure about that. So what's that actually do? Gonna do. Should load that up. But it's slow. Turn that shit up. Turn that stuff up. Let's see. Borders. Place names, day and light. We'll take that back off. Make it brighter. And we're just waiting. Land cover, terrain, relief. That's kind of cool. Look at the relief. What's this BMG layer? So I guess it's the BMG layer 4. Oh, that's how it works. So, okay, whatever. We got so much shit going on here. Keep running. We'll put the BMG layer back in. All right, long lines. Yeah, that way I can tell where I'm at. And they're fighting, you know, you notice the real thing here? This is the cool part. They're fighting above the Arctic Circle. That water is cold. I need some coffee. That water is extremely cold up there. Come on, boys. Do something for me. 100 points. That's all I need. But I am not sure. See, if I killed them all, I would assume that tactical victory would show up. Best way to demonetize something? Ooh, you see, I found that out today. Best way to demonetize a thing and give credit. Just a background noise. Not to make them good, but yeah, this right here, automatic demonetizations, do not worry about it. As long as they don't hit me with copyright strikes, I'll be okay. But that's fine. I'll get one and then I'll stop it. But I read that, you know, if you got a playlist, you can play them. Because of the music recognition that automatically demonetizes it. And if this thing makes any money, it has commercials, I guess. And that monetization goes to the artist, which I totally agree with, and I think that's only right. What I want to do is bring back some of the old music you don't hear, out of the 60s, some of the 70s, maybe even to the 50s. And just songs that you don't hear. But this song, this was in the 60s, so we don't really have Soviets or sortie. The next one, just bear with me, guys. Just bear with me. I will get this to work. Not to work, but I will get into the big fights. Do in window 2. This is annoying. Do the background. Now displays, we want displays. I always have to go through all this junk with this crap. I'll be right back with you. There we go. Just have to do something. first person. Inappropriate colloquialisms. I don't know what the fucking is. How's it going? Two hours to go. I would sure love to find them all. So, I guess the summation for this would be the summary for this would be that I changed the search area to one large search area and put all the aircraft in there and set them to 3 and 3, which means one-third of them would be out at any one time, which gave me a lot of aircraft out there. But I'm just really wondering why I can't. I'm just saying that it would be, God, I just don't know where they're at all. They're just, I mean, it could be, and every time he says radar control, I kind of freak out. I just, and there better be one left. Hopefully it shows us the map when it's done. But to go through a review here, so this is the damage report. This is the ships that sink. Don't really need that. We had 12 aircraft. I think we shot them all down. Here's the units we lost. The Bergen, the Fraser, Almanet. I can't even say that. The vampires did not show us what type of missile system it was. That needs to be addressed whenever it impacts. Do they have that? We had all these goblin contacts, and we had 90 changes of it. But still, again, my curiosity. There's the events of everything that got sunk. I really don't know. I hope this thing goes by soon. Some background noise. It doesn't really need to be that loud. You know, the thing I'm having a hard time doing is a constant talking. This is interesting. I mean, trying to maintain. Ooh, I can send a chat out. Let's send a chat out. See if anybody's there. Probably not there, but let's do that. But I hope to get more people. I mean, you guys are watching these things, and I'm just as happy as you can be. Okay, so and for the people that are just joining or just joining and want to know what's going on, no Patreon. Most of the time, this stuff's going to be demonetized because I got a song playing in the ground. And the demonetization is perfect with me. I mean, because the artists need whatever monetization this gets. I don't doubt as much, but I think it's just good to have. I like old songs and songs that are hard to get a hold of, or you know, people haven't heard for years. Which brings me up to another subject. Who here has heard of the Finger Barn in Aspen, Colorado? You can look it up. It's the Finger. It's not there anymore because a four line went through there, but it used to be owned by Meatloaf. And him and his wife had a very, very bad falling out. And this is true. Had a very bad falling out. And she left him. But she stayed elsewhere in Aspen. But she had to fly to Denver to work. So she would fly back and forth, you know, 2-3 times a week. So Meatloaf, in his prime thinking outside the box, painted a big blue finger, the fuck you finger, on there. So every time that she flew over that barn, she'd get flipped off. And he was just giggling about that for years and years. Now, I went back and tried to find it today, and very little of it. People don't remember. They don't go back that far. So for you older people, if you remember Paradise by the Dashlight Light. And in that song, he talks some of it about it, and how they got a good time, and then, you know, he's just wishing it would get over by the end. Basically, that's what happened. It was very good. I loved Meatloaf. He came back twice. I wish he'd come back again. One hour. We'll get our victory. And then we're going to do a Wahoo. But anyway, that part of Aspen, actually it wasn't in Aspen. It was Woody Creek. And this is a strange part of Colorado. So back there, you know, you had Hunter Thompson. Let's see, Hunter Thompson, he owned a place. Hunter Thompson owned a place. Meatloaf owned a place. Kevin Costner has a really, really nice ranch over there towards Independence Pass. Beautiful, beautiful. But Hunter Thompson is a character. He was one of these guys that, you know, he drove up and down this little bitty, you know, run downtown in his convertible with these chicks in the back, and just drive up and down the street with these chicks in the back that he had. He was a real character. But what happened was, and this is true too, you can look it up. John Oates bought a cabin next door to him, and when he went out to the cabin, he found Hunter Thompson's convertible parked in the cabin. And so it goes that, you know, John Oates said, well, why is he parking in this cabin on property he does not own. And then the real estate person, the only thing they said back was, this is Woody Creek. You have to figure it out. So I guess it was a really interesting place back then to live. Because you had high-profile people living with, you know, living in a place that was really not. I mean, the bar's still there. It's kind of junky, old bar. But, I think they probably have his seat in there. But, you know, it was really interesting. 1 hour, 8 minutes. Man, come on. When you watch it, it's just horrible. I've been watching it for the last 6 hours. So in the next video, which will be, I'm not sure where it's going to be, after this fight's done, we're reducing their attack submarines. And I'm assuming that the next fight is going to be, carrier fights. And basically what I would expect out of that is we bring our carriers are coming in through, coming up, pushing up this way. And the biggest part the whole issue of this is because of this place right here. And this is where the main base for the Baltic Sea, where the Black Sea comes out into the Atlantic, and they'd have to come out and they'd come down here. That's why the fight's over here, because they all came out of here and were trying to get down here through the Soso net, and which is the reason why they built the Soso's net, which were bottom listening phones, sonars. I sure wished I would have been able to catch more. I wonder if there's more. And if there aren't more, I'm going to get pissed off, because and you as the viewer should be upset about that too, is, you know, if I have killed all the submarines, I should get a victory condition. I should get a victory condition now when this scenario ends, because we have $550. So a major defeat to start off. Oh, okay, so I got to be real. It took me 3 tries to get this far. And I think what really changed it is when I just ignored the 2 different ASW zones and turned it into 1 big ASW zone, so there was no fighting over this center line. And then you could turn. Then we turned on, prosecute anything that's within your weapons range. So, but he's doing good. Did he still have his? He still has aircraft. Maybe I should send some aircraft out there. I may not have control over his aircraft. We could throw some aircraft out here in front of him. Find out why air operations. Not getting any. They could be readying. I don't know. But he's definitely not going to let me get to him. So we found most of them right in here. Found one over here. Found most of them sitting in here. And then a missile boat sitting back here. Which kind of drove me nuts because I couldn't figure out where those missiles were coming from. And if you do this, then you will find out that these missile boats don't play. So like I said earlier, if you're just joining us and you have a question or something, please ask it in the chat. I do watch the chat. It's a little behind, but I do watch the chat. I'm trying to keep this very simple, so the chats will work that way. And I don't know who did this. I think my arch nemesis Hooligan might have had a lot to do with this. He makes great, great scenarios. Man knows what he's doing. I might even give him a prop when we get done here. So once this gets done, don't run off. I will be starting another one in about 10 minutes. And it will be the first 30 minutes. This one, I'm probably not going to delete any. I'm going to let it run so people can see that, no, there's no cheating going on. And I think that's a very important thing that we need to do to get these things, you know, get people to believe us that we're not cheating. We're actually trying to do this the right way. Can't believe I lost that ship. There better be another one out there somewhere. So that's it. Where's my battle conditions? Is it somewhere I don't see it? Okay, the scenario has ended. You will be presented with an evaluation. Outstanding. Got a major victory. I'm very happy about that. So what, we'll go to our expenditures. He lost 2 Foxtrots, 2 Novembers, 2 a Victor, 5 Bears, 2 Whiskies, 2 Zulus. No wonder we had so many of them. A Charlie and that Juliet that was giving me a hard time. My losses were this Dearly class, the Laurent, and the Oslo. So I lost a really important thing, the Oslo. What is a great ship if you look him up. So we get the Oslo. So they're not going to give it to me. I do dislike this thing for that. Maybe we can just search by Oslo. Step charges. This was a good one. Okay, anyway, this scenario is over. I'm very happy about it. I'm not going to restart this because we can move on. And I'm happy. I got a major victory out of this thing. So, that's it for opening move for Northern Holocaust, I guess, or whatever they're calling it. Northern Inferno. So, come back in about 15 minutes and I'll have the next opening gambits of the next one. Okay, have a great day.